agree.
I just feel like it's right.
Actually, the, I do not know how many of you are interested in this talk, contraception.
Every family fish.
I am interested.
Interested, because I had my own doubts and I was telling my husband why. By contraception, because everybody thinks they know everything about contraception.
Now we need.
It's too late.
Emergency.
And that is why I put this as contraception.
Emergency.
Chaos, and I'll tell you why I call it as chaos. Okay, just first I'm going to give a general idea of physiology, anatomy, etc. I don't think, still I will say this you know. Does it work?
Yes, yes,
it works.
Yes.
Okay. So what happens is every month one ovum is getting released. One ovum is getting released either from one of the other ovary. So usually it gets released 14 days prior to the next period. It is not in relation to this period, that is in relation to the next period. Because that is why somebody who has got a 40-day cycle, they will be ovulating on 26th day. So somebody who has got irregular periods, so you just cannot predict when they are going to ovulate. Okay? So what happens, this egg which is released, it moves on to the fallopian tube where it meets the sperm which is going through the uterus, cervix, uterus, and meets the ova in the fallopian tube, the ampullary end of the fallopian tube. So from there this egg which met the sperm already is known as a fertilized egg. This fertilized egg moves down the fallopian tube and it takes almost 3 days to come to this place. Subsequently it gets implanted. So this is basically the physiology. So what is the definition is, we are preventing the pregnancy through various devices. So mainly it involves three general strategies. One is prevent ovulation, prevent fertilization in the tubes, and then prevent implantation in the uterus. So again the same thing, physiology. See, contraceptive pills, most of these combined pills act on the ovaries, preventing ovulation. Most of these barrier devices, they prevent the sperm from ascending to the uterus. Most of the introuterine devices like a copper TM thing, they prevent implantation in the uterus. And then in the fallopian tube, when we do the sterilization, we are just ligating the tube so that egg cannot meet the sperm. Even if sperm ascends to that level, it cannot meet because we have already divided the tube. So when we talk about contraceptive options, it's classified as natural options, over-the-counter options, prescription options, and then permanent methods. So what is a natural contraceptive action? That you are not doing anything. It is age-old method of contraception available. Usually it doesn't cost anything, has no side effects. It just involves some behavioral changes on the part of the male and female partner. So in the male, it could be abstinence. Abstinence means 100% contraception. Coitus interruptus, withdrawal methods. Female rhythm methods, that is finding out when she is ovulating and avoiding her intercourse at that period of time. And the most important is the continuous breastfeeding. Lactational amenorrhea method, which is very important in a low resource settings like our country, some of the underdeveloped countries, it is very useful, this method. I think I am going to take some time. If you want to stop, you can stop anytime. What is lactational amenorrhea method? It's naturally, it uses the breastfeeding and the amenorrhea which occurs at the time of breastfeeding. This can be used immediately after childbirth. So we need to have three criteria. The mother should be feeding only on the breast, no other formula. It's purely, it is known as exclusive breastfeeding. Okay, number two, infant must be fed regularly every 4 hours during the day and at least 6 hours at the night. Infant must be less than 6 months because after 6 months it's not very effective. And the mother must not have had period postpartum. So if this is all these criteria when this latest Narendra method is almost 100% effective, 98 to 99.5% effective. It's a very useful method. When these criteria are not met, and then you have to use another form of thermal planning method. Next is the over-the-counter methods, and most of these are barrier methods, which can be bought without a doctor's prescription. So you have a male barrier methods condoms, female barrier methods, female condoms, spermicides, and also emergency contraception. You can buy over the counter nowadays. Three is the prescription birth control. Usually it is obtained the doctor's prescription. Also needs some degree of mental supervision. Advantages is very convenient, easy to use. Also it's reversible. So what are the prescription birth control methods? Either it could be a combined pills and then progestogen only pills, intrauterine devices, and also barrier methods like cervical cast and diaphragms. Then we go to the permanent birth control methods. I need not say that is either a tubectomy or a vasectomy. Okay, we have talked about different options. We can also classify the options as per the route. Either they are taken orally or injections are given or implants, vaginal, the barrier methods in the vaginal route, intrauterine devices, even surgical. How do you assess the contraceptive efficacy? It is assessed by the failure rate of the contraceptive method. It is called as a Pearl Index. And actually, it all depends on the age and motivation of the user and the method of contraception. Normally, typical user failure rates are a little bit higher than the perfect user failure rates, because in some of the contraceptive methods, it totally depends on the user. So if we talk about the lipoprovera, that is injections here, and then use Norplant, that is implants, sterilizations, vasectomies, they are almost the same, user and actual, both are the same. On the other hand, we see the spermicides and also the condoms and diaphragms, you know, they are all different, they are much lower, because it all depends on the user. Then we will talk about later. So only one thing I want to talk about, condom. Condom is the only thing which can protect against sexually transmitted infections. In addition to the contraceptive effects, there are so many methods of birth control are available, but all of them you have to use condom in addition if you want to prevent sexually transmitted infections. Next is, we have also got a female condom, not widely available. We say its cost is 100 rupees per three. Diaphragm, it is a dome-shaped device which is inserted in the vagina to cover the cervix. It's usually fitted by the physician. Cervical cap, it just goes over the cervix. It also must be fitted by the physician. Spermicides. Spermicides have long been used. They are in different forms, combs, creams, suppositories. And most of the spermicides contain non-oxynonions. And for a long time it has been thought that spermicides prevent sexually transmitted diseases. So what is non-oxynonion? It is basically a type of detergent. It kills the sperm, it kills the plasma membranes of the sperm. So it was thought in the laboratory. That is also kill sexually transmitted infections, diseases. Now, why is it problematic? This non-oxynonion not only kills the sperm, it also damages the vaginal epithelium. That's why it makes the vaginal epithelium more prone for sexually transmitted infections. That is why the latest recommendation is regular use of non-oxynonion may increase a person's risk of HIV, herpes, and other sexually transmitted infections. That is the latest recommendation, CDC recommendations. Non-oxynol can be used as a contraceptive, but it should not be used for the purpose of HIV STD prevention. It should not be used for contraception by women at high risk of HIV infections. Okay, condoms with NIN should not be promoted for disease prevention. Then we have got the sponges which is available in the form of today. This also there are sponges which contain non-oxidant iron. Next we go to this big group which is known as the oral contraceptive pill. This oral contraceptive pill can be divided into two groups. One is a combined pill which contains both estrogen and progesterone. And the other form is one known as a progesterone only pill, also known as a POP. This is combined contraception, that is a progesterone only contraception. So what does a combined pill contain? It contains both estrogen and progesterone. Normally the estrogen is ethinyl estradiol. The older pills, they used to have 50 micrograms of ethinyl estradiol. The latest pills contain 30 to 20. There are low dose pills. Progesterone, it could be of the first, second or third or fourth generation progesterone. Okay, normally the pills what we use contain, nowadays what we use contain either a second or third generation progesterone. I'll tell you what is the difference. What is the mechanism of action of combined pills? It has got a multiple mechanism of action. Suppresses the ovulation and also limits the endometrial growth so that endometrium is not suitable for implantation. And also it thickens the cervical mucus so that sperm is finding it difficult to go through the mucus into the uterus. But what are the benefits? They are very reliable, almost 99.9% effect. Reversible, that is as soon as she stops management, she can become pregnant. Also, in addition to that, most of the time nowadays, I have not used combined oral contraceptive pills for contraceptive purposes for many, many years. I will tell you why it is later. But mainly we are using it for the non-contraceptive benefits, like somebody, a woman who is having a menorrhagia, dysmenorrhea, we are using them to suppress ovulation. We are using in cases of polycystic ovaries, regular age cycles. And also, risk of ovarian endometrial cancer is decreased. Decreased risk of colorectal cancer, decreased incidence of functional ovarian cyst. What are the side effects? Mostly side effects are the effect of hormones, nausea, vomiting, abdominal cramps, which is widely propagated side effect by the patients. Weight gain, I'll gain weight. So somebody says I'll have more breast cancer. So also changes in lateral metabolism, thromboembolism, hypertension, etc. All the others are small effects. So we have to talk about the thromboembolic risk of combined oral contraceptive pills. If a woman is not using any pill, she is at the risk of having a thromboembolism 5 by 100,000. If she is pregnant, she is at the risk of having a thromboembolism 60 by 100,000. There is a difference between the second generation and third generation pills. This market, there is a 10-point difference between the second and third generation. We'll talk about it later. And also we have to think about the drug interaction. Whenever if a woman is taking a oral pill, she is also taking any anti-epileptic medications. She is using rifampicin. She is using some of the antibiotics. It may not work. Probably that woman needs a higher dose of estrogen. Okay, that we have to remember, that she might become pregnant and she might say, you gave this pill, I became pregnant. Next, what are the contraindications? Athlete contraindications or all the contraindications for estrogen. All this contraindication is for estrogen. Personal history, family history, thromboembolism, uncontrolled hypertension, smoker, migraine with RR, diabetes and endocrine damage, history of breast cancer, liver disease, morbid obesity. To summarize, we told about everything, but mainly about thromboembolism, myocardial infarction and stroke. The risk is small. Any associated risk of breast cancer is very, 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 very small. So we have got some missed pill instructions. So what are the oral contraceptive pills available in the market? Malayan in government setting. Malati, they are all second generation contraceptive pills. Duolutan, it contains 50 micrograms. I told you in some conditions, anti-epileptic medication may have to use a higher dose of estrogen. This also second generation pill. Second generation pill. This Novolan and the subsequently just following Femilon is a third generation pill because it contains the third generation for this region, which is a district. Then we have got another pill which is called as Yasmin, which we are using for polycystic ovarian disease. It's a drospirenol, contains drospirenol, but there was a lot of litigation in the US market because they are at an increased risk of developing thromboembolism and also cause hyperkalemia. Next is what is called as a clinician certified. It is not called as a classified as oral contraceptive at all because it contains cyproterone acetate, which is not a progestogen. It is a synthetic steroidal anti-androgen, and then so it is used, but it's mainly used for in cases of hirsutism to regularize cycle and also to control the symptoms. But it is basically it is not classified as oral contraceptive. Next, in addition to the pill, we have also got rings in the market. They contain estrogen and progestogen. Just see the cost, 700 rupees per month. This ring can be inserted by the patient herself, kept for 3 weeks and 4 weeks you remove. 3 weeks on, 4 weeks off, something like this. It's available in the market in India. We have also got patches. It's not very widely available. This also for 3 weeks patch on, 1 week patch off. Next, we are going for this mini pill or progestogen only pill. It is also called as estrogen free pill because it contains only progesterone. So basic effect is acts on the cervical mucus, thickens the mucus so that it becomes not penetrable for the sperm, difficult for the sperm to penetrate. They contain only the progesterone, they don't contain estrogen. Only thing about this pill, there is no pill free day. That is, she continues to take all the 28 days. She will continuously, if she is for 5 years, she will be taking every day one pill. That is what it is. And also, it's important that she has to take the pill at the same time every day. Maximum 3 hours late, it is okay. But more than 3 hours, she might become pregnant. So, it should be. So, if more than 3 hours taking the tablet, she might fall pregnant. In that case, she has to use additional contraceptive methods. Side effects, mainly all these things are minor effects. Mainly thing is menstrual irregularities. Patients can have some spottings and sometimes going for amenorrhea. Some of the patients, they don't like it. The indications is whatever is contraindication for oxygen, estrogen, these patients were indicated for progestogen only pill. This is not suitable for a woman who is not used to taking tablets regularly. Who is a very busy woman and carrier woman, she cannot take the tablet at a particular time of the day, and who is significantly overweight. So it's not suitable for those type of women. So I don't think any woman is good in taking the tablet every day on the same time. It's very, very difficult really. Whether it's a carrier or non-carrier or looking after the kids, and it's very difficult. Then next we have got injections, which is very good, which is known as a progesterone injection, known as a medroxyprogesterone acetate, 150 milligrams intramuscular injection. It can be given every 3 months. It's really very good. A lot of women like it because you just have a shot after 3 months. It can be 1 week. You can take it this time over.
Yeah,
that's second reminder.
What long way to go? Can you stop it?
Yeah, yes, madam.
Maybe we can have a part 2 in the next meeting.
Okay, yes, fine. I'll finish with this progestogen, and then part 2 you can have it next time. Okay, this is injections which is given every 3 months. Most of the women like it because it just suits them. The only problem is they also get little bit of initially they'll have an infrequent period, scanty periods, and they can go for a period of amenorrhea. Okay, that might be. And then if she wants to conceive again, after stopping the injection, she may take 3 to 6 months to become pregnant. So these are the problems. Now we also have got it is available in the government city. It is a progesterone subdermal implants, which once it's inserted, lasts for 3 years. Okay, in part 2, I'll tell you about the device. Thank you very much.